Tiger's telling him, just get over there a little bit, because when I get that puck, I'm going to put it right there for you to one time it.
Travis wins the draw. Yager to Zetlitsky. Fire! Scores! With 1 second to play, and the Devils win it! How's that for a set play?
You hear the cliche, just like they drew it up. That's exactly what the Devils did last night. They scored just like he drew it up. Pete DeBoer had a play, which he joked about afterwards and said he's done that 1,000 times. He's drawn up a play 1,000 times, and it doesn't always work, but it worked last night. He also said before this game tonight that it wasn't that difficult of a decision to go with Corey Schneider in the net, even though he played magnificently last night all the way into overtime. Here's Pete DeBoer on his decision to go with Schneider in goal.
It was always a decision when you got Marty Brodeur here. I mean, what he's capable of. He can come in anytime, anywhere, and be the best player on the ice, especially, you know, coming back to Canada. So, I mean, that's always a decision. But, you know, we talked about a month ago that, we want somebody to grab this and run with it. And Corey's done that. His last 4 or 5 games have been exceptional. So, that's why the decision was made.
The Devils scored with 3 seconds left in overtime last night, but that's not the record. Scott Gomez, who was in the building last night, scored with only 2 seconds left in overtime against Boston back in 2000. That's the Devil record for latest regular season overtime goal, guys.
Thank you, Deb. What a night that was. He owns a terrific shot. That was his first game-winning goal this season last night. We very often speak of the challenge for an NHL team to play on back-to-back nights. New Jersey's been good in the second half of back-to-backs, winning 7 of the last 8. And you get the impression they arrived tonight looking forward to playing again. Winning in the final seconds maybe breeds that. The referees tonight, Ghislaine Hébert, Tom Kowal, Steve Barton, and Scott Driscoll are the linesmen. Corey Schneider, Jonathan Bernier, the starting goaltenders tonight. Devils start with the line of Adam Henrique, Michael Ryder, Ryan Clough, and we're underway tonight in Toronto. The Leafs with their top unit on to get things started. Tyler Bozak trying to drop this back for James Van Riemsdyk, but instead it's punched in deep by Cody Franzen. Worked ahead by the Devils. Bozak trying to hold the zone, and indeed he does. He missed the first meeting. Van Riemsdyk plays it across for the cutting Phil Kessel, and the net is knocked off the mooring. Jaromir Jagr, his assist on the game-winning goal last night, .1724, passing his one-time mentor Mario Lemieux for 7th on the all-time list. He'll have to get hot to climb the ladder further before the season ends, 31 behind Steve Yzerman for 6th all-time.
And Jaromir Jagr was the one who pointed it out. Remember, Lemieux did it in 500-plus games less, and Jaromir was the first to point that out. So there's still a difference between those stats.
Great company on that list. And for Jagr, the respect for Mario Lemieux, well, that's been evident. He's talked so much about that, even in his brief time as a New Jersey Devil. Corey Schneider plays it ahead. Bryce Salvador works it free and gloved away by Ryan Carter. He's on with Steven Gianta and Steve Bernier. The Leafs, losers of 4 straight in regulation for the first time this season coming into tonight. Here's Schneider once again for the Devils. Jagr on for the first time this evening. His line mates once again, Dinas Zubras and Travis Zajac. Bouncing puck picked up at center ice by Jagr. He's met at the line, taken here by the ex-Devil David Clarkson. And Carl Gunnarsson works this out to center. Deflected off one of the linesmen, picked up here by Zajac. Defended away by the Leafs captain, Dion Phaneuf. And a stoppage here, 1.5 minutes in. Well, Randy Carlyle under fire here in Toronto in recent weeks. Just two regulation victories for his team in the last 25. David Clarkson, 3 goals, 5 assists. New Jersey remembers him as a 30-goal scorer, but the problems, Chico, go way beyond that one player.
Well, and there's a lot of unanswered questions. Randy seemingly was pushing all the right buttons back in early November. Remember last time we were here, the Leafs Nation was on fire. But since then, the goaltending has kind of blown up a little bit in terms of they were using both goalies back then. They were both playing good stats. Now they've gone to Bernier, and he's been okay, but that hasn't gone the way they had hoped. They thought they had more depth than they had. Their scoring has dried up. They say they're coming off their best game, obviously, since the Winter Classic. But that's not saying much because they've had a lot of losses, especially here at home, that have really put them now outside the playoff picture. And who would have thought that would come November 1st, when they were on a roll.
Joke here in Toronto, they're looking for their first indoor win of 2014. They won at Ann Arbor, that shootout against the Red Wings, as Mike Sislo punches this in deep. This is his 6th National Hockey League game, wearing number 9 in white. Andre Loktyanov is back in the Devils' lineup tonight. Knocked down in the offensive zone. Played ahead here for Nazem Kadri. And taken by Mason Raymond. Joffrey Leupel sends this in deep for the Leafs. And back to collect is Mark Fain for New Jersey. Waiting for it, Reed Boucher, the Devils' rookie wing. And sent in deep by Sislo.
Well, there's an equalizing factor. Devils played last night, but the Leafs this morning had about 7 or 8 guys not show up for their skate, and it was compulsory because of a flu that's been going through the team. But, you know, David Clarkson, obviously, it hasn't gone as well as he'd like here. Look at this hit here. He sees his ex-teammate Andy Green, and he just doesn't hit him. But you see that forearm shot. And David Clarkson, like all the Leafs, coming under a little bit of criticism here. And, you know, when David signed, I remember thinking, I hope they present David on who he is. You know, he's a hard-working guy who takes a lot of shots. He's going to be feisty and physical. But don't look for the wow factor. Don't look for him to be scoring goals, you know, every second game. And so it's been a tough start for him. And now that he's come back healthy, the Leafs also going in the wrong direction.
Playing right now on what's essentially a third line for the Leafs, but one that's very important with Jay McClement and Nikolai Kuhlman. Bozak deep in his own end, winds it around the boards in Kessel's direction, shot by Bryce Salvador, is saved by Bernier. Picked up by Volchenkov, redirected in front, Michael Ryder at the doorstep, got a shot away, but it was blocked. The red-hot Michael Ryder nearly giving the Devils the early lead. Punched across here for Bozak for Toronto. Kessel in front, Van Riemsdyk with a shot, and Schneider got a piece of that. Played back here for Phaneuf. Blocked away by a devil stick in front and punched out to center. Here's the Swedish defenseman, Carl Gunnarsson. Return pass for him. He and Dion Phaneuf, partners for practically the entire season, with the exception of 2 games this year. Devils in the midst of a change. Volchenkov couldn't touch that. Eric Jelinek plays it across for Zidlitsky. Nikolai Kuhlman works this back and Phaneuf towards the Devils' end. Phaneuf delivers a hit, but the puck taken here by Travis Zajac. Knocked away by McClement. Zubras takes control for the Devils. Shakes loose of Phaneuf and cycles it in deep. Jaromir Jagr picks up the loose puck, throws it towards goal, shot it wide. Here's Jelena. Chopped out by Clarkson, picked up by Zubras. Back to the point for Eric Jelena. Played forward, but collected here by the Leafs. Missing from the Devils' lineup tonight is John Merrill. They're giving him a rest. He played the last 23. Steve Bernier sends it in deep. Gianta and Carter on the forecheck. Gunnarsson hit deep in the Leafs zone. Bernier along the far boards. Continues to battle for a loose puck. He's tied up but works it back to the point. Andy Green gives here to Fame. Wrist shot is saved by Bernier. Good pressure here by the Devils. Steven Gianta comes up with the puck, cycles it in deep for Bernier. The first go Leafs go chance, centering try by Steve Bernier, comes back to the point and a shot. One-timer by Green that was punched wide. And taken here by the Leafs.
But when a team's struggling like the Leafs, the thing you want to accomplish the most, Steve, is to get the first goal and get it early. Devils coming close, but missed the net on a couple of good opportunities.
Got the sense, everything we've been seeing, hearing, that the Devils have a chance to have the crowd work against Toronto tonight if they can score a first goal here. Mm-hmm.
One thing about the Leafs, I will say this, Steve, they have come in a physical mentality. Some big hits by a lot of players already.
Sislo throws it towards goal. Follow-up try there by Lafayette. Quickly played it with the glove. Has it on the backhand, then a forehand, and gives here to Boucher. Reed Boucher fired it wide. Bryce Salvador with a shot, blocked away in front by Morgan Riley, the 19-year-old defenseman, and it comes all the way back to the Devils' end. It is icing against Toronto.
Well, last night, what made the game exciting was chances at both ends. Now, look at this puck. It's popping up, and nobody knows where it is. And a Devil finds it, and there, Michael Ryder, every time he touches your puck, you think it's going to go in the net. He couldn't quite get to that one. And there again, a puck up in the air. Player's not sure where it is, and that's the one there by Andy Green that I thought, if he could have hit the net, good things would happen. As I look at it, though, Steve, that Leaf was right in the shooting lane, so Andy probably had to shoot it wide.
Schneider behind his goal, works it free. Here's Eric Chelina, a hit for Ryan Clough. Clough's in a good way right now, assists in three straight games as it's punched in deep by Michael Ryder. Clough deep in the zone, battling here, Adam Henrique as well, but it's picked up by the Leafs' leading scorer, Phil Kessel. Got only so far with it, and now recovers and dumps in. Zydlitski back in his own end. Reverses course for Jelena. Got it away from the onrushing McClement and out to center. Second of three meetings between the teams this season. Leafs won the first back on the 8th of November. Zubras dumps in off the near boards. Ridden into the boards by Gunnarsson and taken here by Riley. Fifth overall pick in the 2012 draft, but the puck given up here. Jaromir Jagr deep in the zone. Tied up in the corner. Worked back towards the point, and Green will have to chase it back.
Good news for Devils fans. The Zajac line coming out with a lot of energy, especially Jagr. He's wanted that puck and has had it most of the shifts he's been on.
Taken away here by Toronto. Here's Mason Raymond dropping it back. Blind pass, and he gave it away. Here's Zajac. Puck ridden around the boards by Jake Gardner. And control here by Valchenko. Followed ahead here. Jagr looking for Zajac. Swept away by Toronto and worked back towards the Devil's zone. 8 minutes gone by. In a rare Sunday night home game here at the Air Canada Center. Leafs have had a few this year, but through the years, not many. Gardner backs it off the backboards. Cody Franzen sends Kadri on his way. Nazem Kadri tied up at center ice by Steve Bernier. Taken away. Ryan Carter with a shot. Blocked away. Jelena with a try, and that's blocked as well. Here's Zydlitski following up. Centering try at the doorstep. Carter jamming at it. Steven Gionta with a try, and it's blocked away. Work back towards Jelena. Wrist shot, and that's fired wide. The Leafs under siege. Now Zydlitski walks in and shoots. Save made by Bernier. Can't hold on. Carter with the puck for the Devils. Gardner comes out of the corner and works it across, and the Leafs skated away. What a shift. Kadri, one move too many as Mark Fain made the defensive play. Here's Sislo for the Devils. The Lafayette line back on. Fain with a shot that's sticked away by Bernier and out of play. Nearly midway through the first. No score in Toronto.
Here's a Devils game. Front pressure there. And back pressure there. Now watch how well this works. And this starts a flurry of shots by the third line with Bernier, Gionta, Carter. And look at, they don't give up on the puck. Blocked there by one of the Leafs. Zydlitski, who's just picking up right where he left off last night, takes it down, throws it out front. But you see, Carter couldn't bang that puck out of the air, or he may have had one. And then from the point, another shot. Devil storming the net. Zydlitski pulls it around a Leaf. He goes in. Good save by Bernier. But what a terrific start with lots of energy by these New Jersey Devils in their second of back-to-back games.
7 of the first 8 shots in the game to New Jersey. Green pinches in. He feels David Clarkson a little bit for the second time tonight. Hard hit by Clarkson. Yager hauled down by Phaneuf. Clarkson can't clear the zone. It's worked across here to Mark Fain. His try swallowed up by Kuhlman and controlled by Gunnarsson for the Leafs.
Hey, if I'm a Devil and I'm seeing number 71 David Clarkson's out there tonight, I am keeping my head up. David is in a snarly mood.
Picked up here at center ice. He was beloved in New Jersey for 7 seasons for precisely that reason.
And well, he should be. I mean, his team is in dire straits. The one thing you could dictate is how physical you are. The other stuff, you can't always say, we're going to score, we're going to do this and that, but you can always be into the game, pounding people if possible. Well, tonight's cold hard facts, are brought to you by Frost Brewed Coors Light. And here's where you see shots against per game. And this is the key to what the Devils have accomplished this year. 25 shots is all. Blues, a terrific team we're going to see later. They're also strong, as are the Kings, Blackhawks, and the Wild play a defensive game. But you see the Blues, Kings, and Blackhawks all near the top of their division. So you know how important it is, Steve. Limiting shots will generally also limit scoring chances.
That was a real warning sign for the Leafs. Even in the opening month, when they were winning hockey games, they were being outshot roughly by 10 shots per game.
Good point. That they're not very good in their own end and haven't been, and that's coming back to haunt them.
Ryder over the line. His shot is blocked away by Cody Franzen and picked up here by Toronto. Bozak plays this across. Here's Kessel. Phil Kessel got around Henrik and a save made by Schneider. Klo works it across. Ryder picks it up off the boards. Back to Ryan Klo. Centering try. Oh, it deflected off Bozak and he nearly put it in his own net. Taken away by Gardner and worked ahead by the Leafs.
Wow, like, now if you're a Leaf, is that a sign that things are getting better or they're getting worse? Your old player makes a great deflection. Your goal's got to make the best save of the first period to stop it.
I'm smiling because it didn't go in up on a Leaf. Here's Bernier. Yeah. Take it here. Absorbs a hit deep in the zone by Jerry D'Amigo. Now sending one towards goal from the opposite side with Zelenov.
Good knock call there by the official. I like the way they've let this game get to a flow.
Zidlitsky across. Here's Zelenov again. Wrist shot. Pass save made. Jonathan Bernier. And collected here by the Binghamton, New York native Jerry D'Amigo. No score. 8:15 to go in the first period. D'Amigo over the line, winds it around the boards. Waiting for this is Kadri. Played back towards the point. Saved from long range. Shot by Cody Franzen. Covered up by Corey Schneider. 8:03 to go in the opening period.
Phil Kessel skipping in, recognizing it's Adam Henrik, the defenseman. He says, I can go around him. Watch after this shot, though. Watch how there's two Leafs standing behind the goal line. That's part of their problem. You got to stop in front of the net. And then right in the middle of your screen here, it's Bozak, forgetting which end of the rink he's on, I guess. But look at this deflection. What a gorgeous save by Jonathan Bernier. And he's looking around saying, what is going on here? And right now, that was his ninth save of this game. But the Devils starting in a real good fashion so far.
To give Bozak credit for breaking up the pass across the slot, but my oh my, taken here by Klo and worked across. Return pass from Adam Henrik. Ryan Klo one-hands it deep into the Leaf zone, and Franzen punches it back the other way for Toronto. Taken away by the Devils. Shot by Klo is blocked away by Tim Gleason, one of the newest Leafs. Acquired in a trade on New Year's Day. Lupel plays this here for Mason Raymond. Banks it off the backboard, controlled here by Andy Green for the Devils. And this puck deflects for a stoppage in play. Let's go downstairs to DePlacy.
Well, the Devils are playing on a rare Sunday night, but all three teams from the state of New York are also playing on this Sunday. Coming up on the GMC Intermission Report, we'll show you how the Buffalo Sabres did the Devils a favor. And the Rangers score two early goals, and the Islanders give up two early goals. So we'll have some highlights, and we've got some scores to keep you posted with. And we'll take a look at those wild card standings, which are indeed wild, guys.
Deb, thanks. Devils 2 points behind the Rangers for the second wild card berth we showed you. 3 points behind the Flyers for third in the division. And as Deb told you, those teams are facing each other tonight at Madison Square Garden. We'll update you. Shot by Phaneuf is blocked away by Dinas Zubras. And punched out to center. Quickly on the loose puck is Jaromir Jagr. Plays it across. Jelinek following up, but fanned on the try. Played across, David Clarkson for Toronto. His shot blocked away by Schneider. Clarkson, you might recall, in that first meeting against the Devils back in November, he had an early scoring chance. We really didn't call his name much after that.
No, he looks like he's involved tonight. That was the Clarkson that we remember, right? Mm. Shooting from all over, using defensemen as screens. I guess that hasn't been happening as much up here in Toronto.
Picked up here by Boucher. Got a shot away, but Kessel bothered him just enough. Work back to the point. Salvador. Boucher follows up and sends it back in deep. Waiting for it, Loktionov. Nice job to shield it away from Gardner. Here's Sislo on the puck. Worked across here. Salvador tried to play it for Volchenkov, but controlled instead by Toronto. Start of a four-game road trip for the Devils. Beginning tonight. Montreal the next stop. And then they get their first look at a couple of teams in the West, Colorado and Phoenix. Jake Gardner punches it out to center. Kessel tried to control. Batting it out of midair, Loktionov. Sislo giving chase, but waiting for it is Kessel on the far side and quickly works it ahead. Bozak had it chopped off his stick, controlled here by James Van Riemsdyk. Two members of that top line for the Leafs will represent the United States in the upcoming Olympics, Van Riemsdyk and Kessel. Punched ahead by Toronto and picked up here by the Leafs. Carter Ashton with a shot. It is held by Corey Schneider, and look out.
Well, you like a couple things about this reaction. Carter drove the net, made contact with the goaltender. He was corralled around the throat, and then another Devil came in to help out as well. For your older Devil fans or you young historians, you may remember a player for the Devils by the name of Brett Ashton. Well, this is his kid, Carter, and he drives a net, and then you see a couple of neck holes by numerous players. But, Steve, this is what I'm trying to talk about. The Leafs are desperate. They are in a free fall. Devils want to continue on the uprise. This is the way hockey game with the importance of this game should be played. And what I like about the Devils, they come with energy on the forecheck and puck possession, but they look like they're also ready to defend physically, because they got to know that the Leafs, if they've got any character at all, they're going to come out and try and get the edge and intimidate if they can.
Every indication this was a desperate team in blue as it arrived here tonight. Falling out of a playoff position just days ago, for the first time since the start of the season. Lifted ahead, Gardner back in his own end and picked up here by Toronto. This is Mason Raymond, first year Leaf ex-Canuck. Sent out of the zone by Fain. Worked ahead by Steven Gianta. And the Leafs take this. Here's Kadri at center ice. What a breakout year he had last year. Fifth NHL season, the ripe old age of 23. But he hasn't followed up enough this year so far.
Devils no, started well, Steve, but he, like the rest of the team, really have fallen off. As we're looking at a delayed offside, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know, Corey Schneider was telling me the other day that he and Chris Terrier, the goaltending coach, have really worked at him playing the puck. And, you know, whenever you heard a scouting report on Corey, it was great goalie, stops the puck well, just doesn't play it efficiently enough. So he and Chris Terrier every day They have a chance working on that puck movement. And he says, you know, as you can imagine, Steve, also just playing with Marty Brodeur and watching him and starting to read how Marty addresses the puck before it gets there and the look that he has to where he plays it, he says, has really helped me as well. So I think we can look for more of what the guys in tape just put together from Corey Schneider. That will really help his game as well as his defensemen and forwards.
Some people believe, give it away, backhand try by James Van Riemsdyk, and a big save by Corey Schneider.
Didn't see that coming, did you?
Devils dominating much of the period and nearly gave it away. Franzen with a shot that's blocked away by Henrik.
Fortunately, Schneider did, though. Wow, that's a rare giveaway by the Devils so far.
Quick shot by Kessel, wouldn't go. Follow-up try, they score. Tyler Bozak. And Toronto takes a 1-0 lead.
Well, the Devils could never right the shift after the stripping forecheck by the Leafs to start this flurry. And, this is the play later, and there you see Bozak just rifling in, sneaking through some Devils, and finding a nice rebound. Goes right under the leg of Corey Schneider, and then as Corey tries to lay down, it also goes under his armpit. But that started with a disastrous turnover from behind the net. So the Leafs get what they were looking for, the first goal of the hockey game.
Devils never found their way out of that. And the long try is gloved here by Corey Schneider. Seventh of the year for Tyler Bozak.
But here we'll look at it. Now Bryce looking, thinks he's got some room. Tries to make a tight turn. Thinks he's away to the races. Ah! It hit Ryan Poole's skate. And then the chaos began. And like you said, Devils were never able to get back into a normal situation.
Gunnison winds this around. McClement delivers a hit on Zubras. Sidlitsky can't work it out of the zone. Picked up here by Dion Phaneuf, who dumps into the corner. McClement tries to come out with it, poked away by Marek Sidlitsky. A surge by the Leafs, all it takes to grab the early lead, and now Gunnison back in his own zone. Here's Clarkson. Able to recover is Travis Zajac to take it away.
Leafs going to the penalty box.
Schneider to the bench, and now the whistle.
Well, this is exactly what the Devils needed. 3:22 to go. They'd lost the momentum. And then the ex-Devil David Clarkson, working hard as he has this whole period, gets a little over-aggressive here. Here's 71, trying to go by, loses it. Ooh, that was borderline. Let's see what happens. Oh, no, it wasn't. Didn't see the stick between the legs of Travis Zajac. Travis had no chance to do the crossover.
This Devil's Power Play is brought to you by PartyPoker.com, the official online gaming partner of your New Jersey Devils. If you can dream it, you can win it on Party Poker. Devil's Power Play is in a bad way coming into tonight. 2 for its last 24. Jelena starts out here. Klo to Ryder. Centering try. The one-time shot did not go. Andy Green with the cut down low. And it's clear.
Well, it was a bouncing ball all the way from the pass till it got to Andy. And he was trying to time it to catch it in the middle of that bounce, but only got a small piece of it and it went wide.
Leafs penalty kill unit among the bottom feeders in the NHL, ranked 27th in the league. Offside is the call here.
Well, let's look at who's been the top power play scorers for the Devils. It's going to surprise you. Marek Sedlitsky at number 5. Michael Ryder, a forward, at number 4. Then two more defensemen, Jelena and Green. And that's pretty impressive. Only Jelena would have, like, the type of shot that you think, you know, most defensemen should score with. Although Andy Green sneaking down, and Marek Sedlitsky starting to get his game in gear in terms of accuracy. But he's always had velocity, Steve, but his accuracy has been so much better recently.
This is on pace for one of his best offensive seasons of his NHL career. I'll crunch some numbers later. Played across here, looking for Steve Bernier. It's Jágr, but it's cleared away again by the Leafs. scoring on the Toronto goal. Bozak is seventh from Van Riemsdyk, and Kessel at 15:53. That's where we are now, a 1-0 game. Jágr got only so far. Cody Franzen with the clear. This is a good penalty kill so far for Toronto. Here's Marek Zidlitsky for the Devils. 40 seconds to go and the man advantage. Steered aside by Jonathan Bernier. Here's Andy Green. Worked it back to a point. A little bit too aggressively and all the way back to Corey Schneider. As Green collects. Devils change some personnel. Adam Henrique will guide this in deep. Coming away with the puck, work back to the point. Here's Jelinek, plays it down low. Redirection by Ryder, comes back to the point again. Jelinek fires it, went wide off the backboard and cleared again by Toronto. Final seconds of the tripping penalty against David Clarkson. He's out of the box. We're back to 5-on-5 as Clough skates this away for New Jersey. Here's Ryan Clough over the line. Feeds Giunta. Shot up high. Following up is Clough. And Bernier on the follow-up made the save again. Fane pinching in. Behind the net, Clough. Able to control. Throws one in front. Kicking at it is Ryder. Loose at the side of the net. And taken away here by Riley. Raymond tries to punch it out of the zone. And now played across here for the dangerous Phil Kessel. Puts the brakes on. That pass batted down by Giunta. 40 seconds to go in period one. Gardner back in his own end for the Leafs. Gets it back from Fanuc. Jake Gardner to Kessel. Steers it into the devil zone. Now Volchenkov with Bozak on his tail. In the corner, work free. Kessel comes up with it, plays it across. Quick shot fired wide by Fanuc. Now Gunnarsson back to Fanuc. Final surge here by the Leafs in the period. Gunnarsson shot blocked away by Bernier. And the Leafs still able to hammer it back in deeper. Final seconds of period one. And the Leafs will go to the locker room with a 1-0 lead over New Jersey.
Well, good news and bad news. Devils started well, Steve. They created scoring chances, 13 shots, but no goals, which has been a ringing theme for them, not scoring on some of their good chances, and now they find themselves behind by one.
Well, if you're looking for a fun night out with your friends, head to The Rock to catch a Devils game with the Girls and Guys Night Out package. For one low price, you'll get a hot dog, a drink, and a ticket to see the Devils take on the Blues January 21st or the Avalanche February 3rd. Log on to NewJerseyDevils.com/promotions for a complete list of Girls and Guys Nights and to secure your seats. 1-0 game in favor of Toronto. Tyler Bozak with the game's only goal thus far. Let's go downstairs. Deb Placey is with Middletown, New Jersey's own James Van Riemsdyk.
James Van Riemsdyk had a hand in that goal that has the Leafs up 1-0. What do you think of the first 20 minutes?
Yeah, it's a hard-fought game. It's fast out there. We know how the Devils play. They're really strong defensively and definitely can score when they get the chance, so we got to eliminate those.
Needing a win, do you feel like your team is playing with a healthy sense of desperation?
Definitely. I mean, obviously, when you get in a skid like this, you got to up your desperation level, and I think we've done that so far, and we'll have to continue to do that.
New Jersey-born, going to represent Team USA at the Olympics. What do you think you're looking forward to most about Sochi?
Yeah, it's going to be a huge thrill. Anytime you can put on the red, white, and blue, it's a huge honor, and to do it in a stage like the Olympics, you can't ask for anything more than that.
All right, well, we'll be watching. We'll be watching the next two periods as well. Thank you, James.
Thank you.
James Van Riemsdyk, they call him JVR here. He is a part of the 1-0 lead that the Devils need to come back from. It's the GMC Intermission Report. We'll take a quick break and come back to the Air Canada Centre in Toronto. A lot ahead, including some of the other scores and highlights around the league.
Here in Toronto, Leafs lead the Devils 1-0 after one. The big story earlier today in the National Hockey League, coaching change in Winnipeg, where the fans want playoff hockey, and right now they're not on course to have it this year. So after a fifth straight loss last night, the Jets part ways with head coach Claude Noel. Their record is 19-23-5, replaced today by the former Carolina Hurricanes head coach Paul Maurice, who got a team to the Stanley Cup final back in 2002. Chico, I know you like Claude Noel as a coach. What'd you make of this today?
Well, it's something that the Jets had to do, but the problem is not coaching. You know, they've tried to move Bufflin from defense to forward. He's underachieved. Kane, who I like at times, can be lost for games on end. Their goaltending, Pavlik, who's one of my favorites, he hasn't performed that well. So, you know, that's what teams have to do, but it's unfortunate. And I like Paul Maurice, but I don't really know if there's enough buttons to push there for him to get that team into the playoffs. I think they're done for the year in that regard.
Better than 1,000 games of NHL coaching experience for Paul Maurice. Now we'll see if the other shoe drops in Winnipeg. A lot of people feel that's a team that's a candidate to maybe unload some very valuable players as we move a little bit closer to the deadline. We're roughly 7 weeks from that, so they've got some time to sort this out and time to get back in the race, perhaps, potentially.
Oh, you're right, and I think Stan Fischer mentioned, I think Bufflin can be had. You know, it's going to take a significant player. I think he could be had in a trade, and even Evander Kane. But a team would have to give up something, and I'm not suggesting the Devils are in that position, but I could see both those guys moving by the trading deadline, or one or the other, maybe not both of them.
Devils need a goal here, getting set for the start of period number two at the Air Canada Center. Pete DeBoer's team trying for a three-game winning streak. It would be just the second the Devils have produced this year, back on November 16th through the 20th. And if you recall that stretch, they beat some impressive teams, Pittsburgh, Anaheim, and Los Angeles in succession. Looking for a goal to even things up here. So the second period begins. New Jersey Devils hockey is being presented to you by PartyPoker.com. Off the faceoff, it's controlled by Toronto, and Dion Phaneuf works it ahead for the Leafs. Jágr back in his own end. Got it away from David Clarkson. But the puck's loose and picked up here by Zubras, who maneuvers it out to center ice. Here's Jágr following up, able to gain the zone. Crossed up with Zubras, and the puck picked up here by Toronto. Zajac on the recovery for the Devils. He's defended well by the Leafs captain, Dion Phaneuf, who pushes it away. Phaneuf was a candidate for the Canadian Olympic team. He was not selected for the group that will go to Sochi. Hauled down as Jaromir Jágr. Second penalty of the game here is against Toronto.
Well, this is just what the Devils needed. Well, actually, they need a power play goal, Steve. As you mentioned earlier, the statistics not real good on their power play recently. But Jágr trying to take that puck down the boards, gets a hand laid on him, and he goes down. And so now the Devils with the opportunity to tie it.
And this Devils power play is brought to you by PartyPoker.com, the official online gaming partner of your New Jersey Devils. If you can dream it, you can win it on Party Poker. It's Adam Henrique who sets in for the draw, but it's one back by Bozak. Digging at the loose puck is Henrique. Ryder and Klo also bunch up as this puck deflects up high and out of play.
Well, last night was, if you could diagram it, you could dream it. The Devils scored. Tonight, if you could dream a power play goal, maybe they'll get one, Steve. But so many parts of their game, you know, doing well, not scoring a lot of goals. But if your power play is giving you nothing, you know, Travis Zajac was telling me that the other day. If you don't come out of that with some momentum at least, you really then seem to sag. You try to guard against it, but it's such a momentum switch, the power play is, whether it's successful or not.
Well, they're going through these waters without the services of Patrick Elias, who remains out of the lineup. Key player in that first wave of the Devils' power play. No definitive word on when we're going to see Patrick back in the lineup. We hope it's soon, as Andy Green takes this for New Jersey.
This is where they miss Patrick Elias, as you may have mentioned, or Deb, I'm sure, did. He's not on the trip, and we're hoping he gets healthy real soon.
Klo works this back. Green controls off the skate. Now tries to maneuver away from McLennan. Andy Green off the boards. Henrique plays this across to Klo. Works it across. Here's Adam Henrique. He shoots. He scores. Adam Henrique from the circle has tied the hockey game.
Well, they're cheering all the way from here to London, or just south of London, where Adam's from. But what a play he makes, Steve. As a shot's self-explanatory. But watch as the play's going to go to the right boards. Now watch this. Andy Green's going to take it down. But right here, watch Henrique hustle over there to give him an out. That was a huge support play. And then the give and go.
Zajac, I believe it was Klo, excuse me, for his fourth and four games. Nice pass here by Ryan, but what a snapping wrist shot over the blocker to the far side. And just a great all-around play for the young man, Adam Henrique, who has been hot, hot, hot in about the last 10 games.
Say the same for the man with the primary assist. Klo is frustrated. He can't get his first Devils goal, but now helpers in four consecutive games. And Morgan Riley back in his own end, pinned against the boards by Ryan Carter. So the Devils respond early here in period two, and off to the races. Joffrey Lupul for the Leafs plays it across. Kadri with a shot that's saved by Schneider. We're back behind Schneider's net, and here's Andy Green. Henrique's 11th of the year on the power play. Green and Klo with the assists at 1:39 to tie the game. Over the line is Sislow with a drive, and Jonathan Bernier will gather it in.
Well, remember now on this goal, it's not a slap shot. Here's the reverse, but look at Adam Henrique hustle over, knowing that Green's getting isolated. He needs help. He gets there, but look at this shot. That's a snapper. That's a wrister. That's not a slapper. Look at how the height of the puck, the accuracy just clipped the inside of the pipe and landed right where Adam was maybe dreaming about it. Maybe he was.
Slow start for Henrique, but he's really picked it up now for the Devils.
Well, I said you got to dream it first, Steve, before the reality comes. And I got to tell you, I think that's something that a lot of players dream about, is snapping the puck from that mid-range. Because if you can start scoring from there, boy, your totals are going to increase rapidly.
Taken here by New Jersey and fired in. Up high off the glass. This stays in play. And it's punched across here to Morgan Riley. Hopped over the stick of Zydlitzky. Devils have to get back onside, and they do. Marek Zydlitzky plays it ahead for Jaromir Jagr. Jagr came up high, and this one's against the Devils.
Well, Jagr's been in the middle of these things. Doesn't like it. There was a little slash as he was trying to get the advantage on this play here. Let's see here now. Oh, you know what? Comes up with his stick off Gardner's gloves, I believe. You know, if the stick strikes in the chest of Gardner, Gardner embellishes a little bit. But I'm sure they're thinking, hey, we gave you a break on your penalty. Now you're going to sit and see what it feels like on the other side of that. So the Devils penalty killing is called upon to come up big at a big time in this game.
This is strength versus strength. The Leafs' power play is good. Better than 21%, fifth ranked in the National Hockey League. Devils' penalty kill unit is ranked third. Franzen plays it across. Phaneuf, redirection. Bozak looking for a second of the game, but Schneider made the stop. Here's Kessel, comes off the boards and fires. Save made. Once again, pops up high. Kicked out here by New Jersey and cleared by Salvador.
Great job by Zubrist, not allowing Kessel to get loose, to get to that loose puck and keep this pressure on.
Bozak, cross-ice pass, picks up James Van Riemsdyk. Winds it around the boards, comes back to Franzen at the point, who punches it back in. Kessel waits for it opposite side. Van Riemsdyk lost his edge. Franzen pinching in, tries to throw it towards goal. Gathered up here by New Jersey and clear. Mike Sislow heads to the bench. Penalty kill continues for the Devils with Travis Zajac and Dinah Zubrist, the forward tandem. Green and Fane on defense. Mason Raymond trying to control on the far boards. Leafs get it back here. Here's Franzen with a shot. Redirected, and it went wide. Fane tries to clear the zone. Held in, though, by Phaneuf. Here's the Leafs captain. Gives to Franzen. Plays it across. Now, Franzen has a pass that hops over his stick. Gathered up here by Green. In the corner, Mark Fane winds it around. Phaneuf waiting for it at the point. Half a minute to go. In the high sticking call against Jagr. Franzen holds. Behind the net. Joffrey Lupul works it back to the point. Here's Dion Phaneuf. Across for Raymond. Walks in. Tries to backhand one towards goal. That's eaten up by New Jersey. Taken away here by Zajac. And he's able to clear.
Devils doing a good job, Steve. Keeping the puck to the outside. And not letting a Leaf get a good chance in that low slot area.
Phaneuf, the outlet pass. Picks up Kadri, who's over the Devils' line, throws it across. Raymond with a shot, saved in by Schneider. It's loose. Punched away by the Devils and taken here by Raymond, who's forced out to center.
Big glove save there by Andy Green.
One more time, Riley with a shot and a riser that goes off the backboard. Back to 5-on-5. Sustained pressure here by Toronto. Centering try for Van Riemsdyk. There is another penalty coming up against New Jersey.
Well, there was some confusion. Bernier didn't race to the bench because he wasn't sure. But here's the Devils penalty killing here. And watch Andy Green's glove here. This is, three games in a row, I think, where Devil defenseman reaches into the crease to save a goal. Andy gets it with his stick first, pops it up, then sweeps it away with the inside of his glove. Just a great goal-saving play by Green and some help from Jelena as well. And then who was the guilty party there?
Reed Boucher.
Oh, a high stick to Reed. Let's see number 15. Okay. Reed came out later and high-sticked someone just after that.
So the Leafs go to the well again at the side of the net. Van Riemsdyk able to work this back to the point. Cody Franzen's on it for Toronto. Quick shot, saved by Schneider. They score on a rebound. James Van Riemsdyk.
Well, tough play for Reed Boucher. Doesn't get a lot of ice time. Then he takes a penalty just after the Devils have killed one off. And the New Jersey native Van Riemsdyk showing the quick hands, though. Look at this. This rebound, maybe a foot and a half away from Schneider. But when you got someone like Van Riemsdyk and you're a goaltender, you've got to direct that into a corner or keep it on your body. And that's tough to do. Big shot there by Granson, who has a pretty hard shot. And the big guy buries one. He was red hot earlier in the season. He's cooled off like a bunch of the Leafs, but that's his 17th now of the season to give the Leafs the lead once again.
34 points for Van Riemsdyk, and the Leafs' bread and butter has been that top line, Kessel and Bozak, and they've regained the lead. Michael Ryder tries to work this out of the zone, but it comes to Mason Raymond. Centering try by Toronto, taken away though by Ryder, and deflected here towards the stick of Zidlitsky. Long pass for Klo. Ryan Klo is in. Backhand try. He scores! Ryan Klo, his first as a Devil, and just like that, the game tied again.
Don't tell me Ryan Klo doesn't have speed, especially with someone chasing him. Just a brilliant pass out of the defensive zone. I don't know if it's, yeah, it's Zidlitsky. Wow, what a game season he's having. But look at Ryan Klo. He feels the back pressure, Steve, but he's still going to try something. He's not just going to snap the shot right into the goaltender. He looks around, no option to pass. Then he takes it, and Bernier backs up a little bit. Bernier gives up the challenge here, and that allows Ryan to take the puck from his forehand to his backhand, and then he has room to lift it up. Congratulations to Ryan, who's been a great helper the last four games, but now he just goes and does it himself, scores his first of the year.
The goals are 27 seconds apart. So an eventful opening 6.5 minutes of period two, and here come the Leafs looking for more. McClement left the puck behind them, jarred away by Green. It's a 2-on-1 for the Devils. Here's Travis Zajac, across for Yager, and a shot that wouldn't go. Yager once again from the sharp angle, rang it off the pipe. Chances galore for Jaromir Jagr, who's got the puck again. Zubra sends it in deep. Now Zajac plays it across. Andy Green cutting towards net. He's worked well in that situation before, trying to bat it out of midair. Zidlitsky fired it in. There's a broken stick, and we'll step aside. 2-2 at the Air Canada Center.
Here's what gets the Leafs in troubles. Now, it's 2-2 and they get anxious. And watch Phaneuf. This is not a good time for a defenseman to make a play at the blue line and leave your partner out to dry by himself. What a pass by Zajac right through the legs of Gunnarsson. But it was bouncing again, and Jarmer couldn't get enough stick on the puck. He got a second chance, hit the outside of the pipe. But his line has been looking good tonight. And we've said it before. We said it last night. The Henrique line is up and at full strength. They're scoring goals. And Devils just hoping that Zajac, Zubrus, and Jager can start to chip in now as well.
Do some house cleaning here. Van Riemsdyk gave the Leafs a 2-1 lead. Franzen and Kessel get the assists on that blow. Zidlitsky, the lone assist on the tying goal from Ryan Clough. At 6:23, and we're back to where we started. We are tied. Picked up here by Steven Giunta. One hands went deeper into the zone and played across to Jake Gardner. Here's the teenager, Morgan Rielly. Got it as far as center ice. Giunta picks that off, and it's dumped back in by Steve Bernier. Steered aside by Jonathan, and now Carter in the corner for the Devils. It's jarred loose, taken here by Adam Henrique. Sticked aside by Bernier. Waiting for it at the point is Andy Green. Sends it in deep, off the boards. Ryder trying to control. Now Ryan Carter sends it behind goal. Henrique works it back to the point. Shot by Fain, saved by Bernier. And hammered away. Fain quickly back.
Come on, ref. Cole Norris just working over Ryan Carter. Cross-checked it and punched it in the back of the head. And no penalty. But Andy Green even steps up and says something to Colton-Hart.
And the crowd is booing because Carter wouldn't oblige him. Here's Kessel with the power move. Those crashing into the boards. So check that. That was James Van Riemsdyk.
That was a good non-call. The crowd's in a frenzy right now, Steve. They want some penalties called, and there hasn't been any. But the referees have done a good job, or they're going to call one now. But it's going to be against, the Devils.
And now the touch is made. Let's see what we have. It's a high stick.
High stick. Wild, wild minute here. Non-penalty. Now watch Colton Orr here now. I don't know why he tries to. And then there's a nice little hit. Watch. Now that's not a penalty. Okay. How about this one? The second one? No. Wait. Well, there's just more. There's one more. I'm going to say it called something. But no. No penalty there. And then just moments later, it's the Devils. Oh, this is the rush by Van Riemsdyk. They wanted a penalty. That beautiful play by Valchenkov. Didn't hook, didn't interfere. Oh, and there, I'd like to see another look at that. I don't know. Cody Franzen, he said he got hit in the face with a stick. I don't know whether he did or not. I don't want to question the guy's integrity on that play, but it's Adam Henrique's stick was high, but I didn't see the contact there, but I could be wrong.
Well, the Leafs power play is 1-for-2. It's going to work again. And the Devils get a quick clear to get this started. Henrique the guilty party. Phaneuf on the power play here for Toronto. Drops it back. It's Kessel. Plays it across. Van Riemsdyk back to the point. And Franzen across for Phaneuf. Now the Leafs set up. Phaneuf dishes off. Quick pass across. Sent back in deep, and now Kessel will collect again. Backhands it across. Franzen picks it up off the board. Shoots, pad save by Schneider. Kessel controls, works it back for Phaneuf. Dion Phaneuf fires. It's deflected away into the corner. Franzen is on the loose puck here for Toronto. Back for Phaneuf again. The Leafs captain dishes off. Kessel's got it. Van Riemsdyk is the man in front. Phaneuf dishes off, went through the legs of Kessel. He says no problem, picks it up off the far boards and drops it back. Phaneuf, shot saved by Schneider. Rebound loose, they score.
They're waving it off, Steve. They're saying that Schneider got knocked down on the play. Don't know if there'll be a penalty, incidental contact, but the referee very quickly saying, no, this is no goal, and well, the faceoff's gonna be outside the zone. Now let's take a look here, what's going on? I don't know. I can't hear, Steve, what they're ruling it. Yeah, let's see. There's Van Riemsdyk. Whoops. I don't see him making contact with Bernier, so I'm not sure. He's outside the crease. No contact. No contact. Wow. Did you get the ruling?
Minimal. No.
I think if it was Van Riemsdyk, it wasn't a penalty. As a matter of fact, whatever devil that was actually knocked Van Riemsdyk's skates out from under him.
Shot by Giunta is saved by Bernier. And taken here by Gardner.
worked across, and the Leafs quickly back in the zone once again. Played back here. Riley danced through some defenders and holds and plays it in deep for Kadri. Final 25 seconds of the man advantage here for Toronto. Lupul works this back for the point, and Gardner across. Here's Jake Gardner at the point. Holds, gives here to Riley. Played in deep. Kadri beyond the net. Puck jarred loose. Gardner is able to collect this. Giunta staying close to him. Played ahead, and here's Kadri once again. Final seconds of the man advantage for the Leafs. Nazem Kadri. Henrique's out of the box. Gardner plays it across. Pass deflected off Riley's stick, and Henrique sends it ahead. Here come the Devils the other way. It's a two-on-one emerging here. Taken here. Quick shot. Rang it off the pipe. The shot by Sislow, and now another penalty's coming up. This time it's against Toronto as Jelinek retreats back in his own zone.
What a wild second period.
Jágr plays it back. Delayed penalty call against the Leafs as Klo holds here for New Jersey. And played across for Zubras. Jágr, all delayed penalty time. Deflects back, and here's Jelinek for the Devils. Still no touch by the Leafs. Zydlitzky bumped at center by McClennett, and now that'll do it for the stoppage. Devils power play goes to work when we come back.
Fifth penalty of this period, and you're going to see Kadri racing up.
And I guess hauling down Henrique.
But right after that, you saw Ryan Poole get his first of the year. Mike Sislow, 3 inches inside the pipe, but he's got his first. But it rings off the outside. And the Devils, at least now, with the score tied 2-2, have a chance to take the lead.
This Devils power play brought to you by PartyPoker.com, the official online gaming partner of your New Jersey Devils. If you can dream it, you can win it on Party Poker. Off the draw, this is controlled by Michael Ryder. Andy Green across to Jelinek. Those are the point men. His shot is held by Jonathan Bernier.
Oh, I like everything about that play. I just wish Eric hadn't gotten quite so wide. You know, and he didn't need to. If he's inside the circle, now watch here. Watch how wide he is. He's way over by the boards. If he can get that just a little bit more inside, he'll have a bigger shooting area. But a good start, good feel for Jelinek to get that puck on this power play and let it rip.
Another face-off win by Henrique. Andy Green walks in and shoots, and Bernier holds on again.
Nice puck movement by the defenseman here. And the Devils winning these face-offs cleanly, Steve. We saw Zajac last night in one of the biggest wins of the year. And here again on the power play, a nice win. Adam Henrique, what a game he's doing. But he has to. Mom and Dad are here, brother, friends. And he's doing it all.
Off the draw, Phaneuf trying to get it out of harm's way for the Leafs. He's tied up. Henrique worked it back. Big shot. Jelinek save again by Bernier. It's what Eric Jelinek brings. Taken here by Henrique. Green again. Gets it across to Jelinek. Henrique got it back to the point. Green off Jelinek's skate. He'll recover. Devils trying to make something of this as it's guided back to the point here. Andy Green with a shot deflects into the corner, and it's taken again by Jelinek. Played down low. Michael Ryder tied up by Phaneuf. Henrique got it to Klo, and now back to Jelinek at the point. Works it across. Here's Ryan Klo. Jelinek once again lays it across for Green. Andy redirected by Ryder and sent wide. Picked up here by Henrique. Good pressure here by the Devils on the power play. Jelinek again fires, and it's deflected wide. Eric Jelinek holds the zone. Now McClennett trying to get it away, and it's cleared away by Bozak.
Hey, can't argue with that power play so far, Steve. Devils were letting the puck rip at the net, and that's what you want. You want at least 5 or 6 attempts on a given power play, if possible.
Now Zydlitzky steps on to continue the power play. Jágr across to Reed Boucher. Runs smack into Tim Gleason. Puck taken away. Back to the point. Zajac is covering there and holds the zone. Gives it here to Jágr. Trying to work it back to Zajac. Pass picked off and dumped away by Van Riemsdyk. A dozen seconds to go. Jágr. One last rush on the Devils power play. Gives here to Boucher. Drops it back towards the point. Zydlitzky. sent it only so far, and it's sent the length of the ice. That will do it as Kadri comes out of the box. Zydlinski smoked out for the Devils. Puck taken away. Oh, Kadri nearly had a chance there, but skated away by Zubras. Across for Boucher. Tries to split two defenders. Dynas following up as well. Riley plays it around the board. Shot by Salvador goes high and wide. Picked up here by Fane. At the side of the net is Zubras. He'll gobble up the puck and control. Sent back in deep. Gianta back to Salvador. That's softly deflected into the corner, but Carter plays it behind the net. Centering try by Gianta. He takes a hit. Zubras takes the puck. One-timer by Carter is saved by Bernier. Five-on-five pressure here by the Devils. Riley trying to work it away for Toronto. No can do. It's Ryan Carter who punches it back to the point. Salvador holds the zone. Give it here to Gianta. Gianta throws it towards goal. That didn't miss by much. Punched in deep by Fane. All pressure time for the Devils here with under 5 minutes to go in the middle period.
Penalty now to Salvador, fighting for the puck. His stick springs loose and hits a leaf in the mouth.
Bernier to the bench. The Leafs get the extra attacker on, but now the whistle. 4:44 to go. We'll watch the Devils penalty kill work when we come back.
Back at the Air Canada Center, we're tied at two, but stay with us for the Mazda Intermission Report. We'll have a chat with Ryan Clough right outside the Devils' dressing room. He gets his first goal as a Devil. Plus, Cam Janssen, in his own words, a player that over the years has always had to fight for every inch, fight for everything he's gotten. The power plays continue. Let's go back to Steven Cheeko.
The fourth Devil to be guilty of high-sticking in this period is Bryce Salvador. Valuable player on the penalty kill, too. Henrique takes the draw. Bozak steps in for Toronto and wins it back. The puck gobbled up by Kessel. And the Leafs power play to work again. Van Riemsdyk using those quick hands at the side of the net. Got a shot away but was stopped. Played across here. Fanuf. Backhands went in deep. Puck winds around. Kessel waiting for it. Jarred away from Adam Henrique. Van Riemsdyk just had it taken away by Andy Green. Delivered the check and got the clear.
Yeah, great body position by Andy Green, but Van Riemsdyk, can't say enough about some of the New Jersey people. Bobby Ryan, some great set of hands in the National Hockey League that have been developed in New Jersey.
Second overall pick back in 2007, played across by the league. Taken away by New Jersey, and Zubras one-hands one in the direction of Steven Gianta. Short-handed shoots and fires wide. That duo to the bench. Carter, Henrique step on to continue the kill. Here's Franzen on the move for the Leafs. Dropped it back, and he missed with Phil Kessel. This Phil Kessel gets his legs moving with the puck. The whole rink backs up. Taken here by Kadri. Slowed up by Fane, but now the Leafs set up. Mason Raymond back to the point. Here's Dion Phaneuf. Franzen across, picks up Raymond, who shoots, blocked away and taken by Henrique.
Well, Phil Kessel had a rough shift. You mentioned he missed that pass. Then he got knocked down and wiped out by his own player. He said, I've had enough. He just went to the bench.
And a clear by Andy Green once again. 20 seconds to go on the penalty to Bryce Salvador. 3 minutes left in period two. Geoffrey Leupel on the move for Toronto. Able to play it across. He's got Gardner, who punches it off the backboard. One-handed out of the zone by Mike Sislow, and Kadri has got it. Penalty time is up. Salvador is out of the box. Nazem Kadri for Toronto. Picked up off the boards here by Raymond. Over the line, puts the brakes on, tried to play it across. Jágr got in the way of that. Tied up in the corner is Kadri, bothering him. Zydlinski, and now Andy Green takes the puck away for New Jersey. Steered ahead by Jágr, and this will be an icing call against the Devils with 2:16 left in the period. Here's the Tri-Honda Dealers game recap to this point. We're tied at two. Tyler Bozak and James Van Riemsdyk have the goals for the Leafs. Adam Henrique and Ryan Clough. His first as a Devil. He's working on a two-point night. Face off to the right of Corey Schneider. Trying to find the puck off the draw. And Yager is able to play this back. Zydlitzky across here for Green. Devils coming off a pretty successful homestand. They took 5 of a possible 6 points trying to get the road trip started in positive fashion tonight. Lukianov plays it across. That pass got by Sislo. Devils are pinned in a bit just by the Leafs as this is fired away by Zydlitzky. It's another icing call.
Well, it hasn't gone well for the Leafs at home recently, Steven. We've seen some of the reasons why when the Devils have hemmed them in as convincingly as they have. But at home in the last 2 games, they've been outscored 12-4. Tonight is better. They have won the last 5 meetings between these 2 teams. Mm. But, you know, I'm thinking they played so well at times. How can that be as we see a timeout coming? But my point is when I see them getting running around and the Devils dominating, I say, okay, that's why these times are getting so tough for Randy Carlyle and his team. And the Devils just have found a way again, Steve. You know, they get knocked down. They get scored upon first. They fall behind 2-1. But then they come back with that quick goal. They're just so resilient. And I was thinking of, like, Mike Sislo doesn't play a lot. Then he goes out, does a great job of killing off the penalties. Hit the post there on the one scoring chance he had. So this Devils team really shaping up to play what we have become accustomed to in New Jersey, and that is a team game from goalie on out and through from start to finish.
Big parts of the offense right there, Zydlitzky and Yager. So the Devils with another faceoff deep in their own end. It's Lukianov who will take the draw against Bozak. And the faceoff is controlled by the Devils as Jaromir Jagr takes for New Jersey. Jagr is over the line. Reinforcements off the Devils bench. Jagr gives this up for Dinah Zubras. Backhand try. It's held by Bernier. Time now for the Cadillac trivia question late in the second period. Who's the only defenseman in Devils history to have an overtime goal in the regular season and in the playoffs? That man got one in the regular season last night. Marek Zydlitzky. I mean, is it obvious? Is it Scott Niedermeyer? Find out. Enough for David Clarkson. Jagr tied up at center ice. Nikolai Kuhlman works this back for the Maple Leafs.
I'll tell you what's one thing that's happening here in a minute, Steve. David Clarkson is trying to get under the skin of Jaromir Jagr. He's chased him down a couple times. There he threw a bumping check, and Jagr looked at him. You know what usually happens? See, Jagr wasn't on David's team, so he doesn't feel bad hitting him as much as he might a friend. Not that he would give up a chance to do that either. But I think Jagr is on to... There's Clarkson and Jagr again.
He should be warned. You might not want to make him angry. Sometimes he's pretty dangerous, even when he's not. Picked up here by the Leafs. Winds around to the stick of Andy Green. Worked in deep. Collected here by Tim Gleason. Half a minute to go in period 2. Kuhlman softly dumps into the Devils' zone. Gianta, long pass. Carter, able to control. Quick shot by Ryan Carter. Save made by Bernier. He keeps the puck in motion as the Leafs dump it away. Salvador chased back in his own zone. Dion Phaneuf winds it around. Final seconds of the period, but a quick shot there by Carter in the final second that misses for New Jersey, and it's 2-2 after 2.
Well, this one's tied, 2-2. What's there to look forward to in the third if you're a Devils fan? How about this one? Amanda, our stat person, came up with this. This is a good one. The Leafs have allowed 55 third-period goals this season, the most in the NHL. And the Devils, again, are hoping to add to that total when we start the third.
27 shots for New Jersey, 19 for the Leafs to this point. A reminder to follow the Devils on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram to get closer than ever to Jersey's team. Check back often for a chance to win great Devils prizes and join the conversation by using the hashtag NJDevils during every Devils game. Log on now. It is Michael Ryder who's had the hot stick coming in to the game tonight. Goals in four straight games. 16 goals so far. He's on pace to score 29 this season. In the last full 82-game season that the Devils played, they had three 30-goal scorers, one of whom is in the building tonight in David Clarkson, Ilya Kovalchuk, Zach Parise. But Michael Ryder is the man who's been on a roll for New Jersey. Will he emerge as the hero later tonight? 2-2, it's a good one here in Toronto at the Air Canada Centre. Second of three meetings between the teams this year. The Leafs won in a shootout back on the 8th of November, spoiling an otherwise solid night for Corey Schneider. Let's see what unfolds tonight. It's already been a good night for Ryan Clough. He's downstairs with Deb.
Ryan, when the season started, I don't know if you would have chosen January 12th as the date that you got your first goal as a Devil. What was the emotion when that puck went in?
Yeah, I don't think it went well. I wanted to wait 3 or 4 months, but it was nice. I mean, you know, you like to get it out of the way more than anything. I think I wasn't too focused on it the last, well, I guess since I came back from my injury, because I really felt like my game was where it needs to be, and I was playing, you know, playing on top of my game, I guess. And I figured eventually it would come, but I didn't think it would come on a breakaway.
Well, you've been racking up the assists. This one you get. Let's take a look at it. Take a look at this breakaway.
It was just a great pass by Zid. I think they're deep pinched, and when I see him pinching, I just took off. I think he was late getting back, and I knew I had some pressure on me, so I just, you know, that's a move I try to use on the shootout a lot. It hasn't been working, but I figured with someone chasing me, it might work better, so I think I slid it under his glove.
So you've got 27 shots on goal. The Leafs give up a lot of shots. You guys have played in so many of these 2-1, 1-0 games lately. Does this one almost feel like a shootout?
Yeah, I mean, I think a lot of it's just power plays. We're just giving up way too many power plays against. You know, I think we just penalties that we can avoid, and you know, we got to be smart. It's the team we're fighting for. We don't give them any opportunities. They're the best power play at home. I think that's hurting us a little bit. But 5-on-5, I thought we'd done a real good job. That's where we generated a lot of shots. So that's our game. We carried it over from last night.
All right, thanks so much, Ryan.
Yep.
Congrats on the first one. Bozek and Van Riemsdyk, Henrik and Clough, your four goal scorers. It's the Mazda Intermission Report. We're at 2-2 straight ahead. It's Cam Jansen in focus, and we'll have that right after this from the Air Canada Centre.
Tonight's second period scoring summary is brought to you by Hyundai. Busy second period for those filling up the scoring sheet. Adam Henrik, his 11th on the power play. Clough and Green, that tied the game. James Van Riemsdyk got the lead to 2-1 Toronto from Franzen and Kessel on a power play goal. And then 27 seconds after that, Ryan Clough's first of the year. What a gorgeous pass from Zydlitzky. And they've added a second assist to Eric Gelinas. Shots in the game, 27-19 in favor of the Devils. Each power play has produced a goal tonight. That man has 2 points in the column this evening. First goal is a Devil for Ryan Clough off a pretty neat move that he said he's tried in the back in the shootout. But with no success, it worked with a defenseman chasing him. Underway tonight in period three. New Jersey Devils hockey is being presented to you by PartyPoker.com. 2-2 game. As Deb told you, Devils have played 7 of the last 8 in one-goal games. This could be destined to be another. Played across, Tim Gleason. Steered into the Devils' zone. Corey Schneider waits for this. Winds it around glass, and it's picked up here by Clough. Picks up Michael Ryder, who's over the line. Drops it back for Henrik. Adam Henrik crosses up with Clough. Works it back to Zydlitzky. Caught up in his skates. Now he shoots. And a whistler that's fired off the backboards. And Kessel picks this up. Van Riemsdyk plays this back for the Leafs. Toronto with 4 straight regulation losses coming in. For the first time this season. Feeling pressure to get a victory. And Bernier couldn't keep it in the zone. It'll come out just outside the Leafs' end.
Well, let's take a look at Michael Ryder's scoring ability. Here's 5 of them. Bang, upstairs over the glove. They're in tight. Chips it short side. They're the wide open net, but he doesn't miss it. Up over the blocker. And then against Florida, the last game, another one. Up high over the mitt. And he's as likely as anyone to break this tie tonight.
Fans wondering what the Devils' club record is for goals in consecutive games. It is 6 by several players. Zach Parise, the last to accomplish that. Ryder is at 4. And counting, perhaps, trying to hold the zone was D'Amigo for Toronto. And now Bernier steers this into the Leafs end. Jonathan Bernier waits for it to get it away from Ryan Carter. Balchenkov, well played, and he ladles it back into the Toronto end. 19-year-old Morgan Rielly circles his net, gives here to Jake Gardner. Pass deflects off D'Amigo. Now Zubras tries to quickly get the Devils started. Played across here to Jaromir Jagr. All-time active scoring leader in the National Hockey League. Plays it across for Zajac. And the one-timer is saved by Bernier. David Clarkson tries to get it out of the zone. Kicked out here by Gardner and worked away by the Leafs as it comes back here to Jake Gardner once again. Opening minutes, period 3 of a tie game. Jagr played it ahead in the direction of Zajac. Now firing in is Mark Fain. Here's Boucher picking up the puck. Tries to get around Phaneuf, but he's sealed off nicely. And now the Leafs try to break out. Pass off the far boards. Kessel in a foot race, but Andy Green is there. Now Green darts back the other way for the Devils. Dishes off here. Sislo drops it back. Good pickup by Lakhdianov, who shoots, and this puck deflects out of play. Cadillac brought us the trivia question. The only Devils defenseman in their history to have an overtime goal in the regular season and in the playoffs. I'm throwing darts at a dartboard here. I'll go with Bruce Driver. Chico?
I'll go Brian Rafalski. We've talked about him recently.
Well,
Marek Sedlitsky would like to accomplish the save. He's got to one during the regular season out of the way. Now he's just hoping to look at the opportunity in the playoffs. Long way away, though, Steve, as you've shown the standings and talked about them. Boy, you know, you might have a good game one night, but you better come up with the same the next and the one after that if you want to ensure yourself being one of the participants in the postseason.
Here's Ryan Close. Sends it towards goal, and the stop made by Bernier. Based on the news a few days ago, we wonder if Rafalski will be part of the playoffs this year. This is icing against Toronto.
Well, let's look at Brian Rafalski in the playoffs. Bobby Holik drops it back. Brian in off a skate. Corey Cross. And we don't have to tell you that's an OT goal as he is swamped by his teammates. And Bobby Holik, way out there in Wyoming, he'd be happy that we featured him on that faceoff.
Gleason off the draw can close here for Toronto. James Van Riemsdyk, top line is on here for the Leafs. Bozak with Kessel and Van Riemsdyk. Gleason back to collect this for the Leafs. 2-2 game. Glad you've joined us on this Sunday night on MSG. Playoff chase intensifies around the NHL. All three local teams in action tonight. Schneider waits behind his goal and works it across. Salvador played ahead and picked up here. Neat little move by Steve Bernier and punched in by Zubras. Bernier will get chase. Gunnarsson gets that away from him. Kuhlman couldn't collect it cleanly for Toronto, but now Carl Gunnarsson follows up the Swedish defenseman, plays this across. Neat little move by Clarkson. He's in. He shoots, save made by Schneider. It's loose at the doorstep, and now Corey Schneider has got it.
Well, we featured David Clarkson early on in the game as he looked like he was really going to try some of the stuff that he used in New Jersey. And I've seen this a few times, the fake shot, the toe drag through the defenseman. And then a big save by Corey Schneider, not just on the first one, but he reaches out. That's Eric Gell, another rookie, getting taken to school there. But Corey Schneider finding that puck with some help from his friends is able to cover it up.
Off the draw, taken here by Andy Green. Better than 4 minutes into the third period. Locked in a 2-2 battle. Each of these teams with 47 points coming into play tonight. Friends in the center. Hacked into the zone by Joffrey Lupul and picked up here by Green. He gave the puck up. Here's Kadri. Works it across. Lupul. Back for Nazem Kadri, and now Raymond tries to come out with it. Mason Raymond back to the point. Gleason has this for Toronto. The redirection sails over Schneider's net.
Toronto buzzing here as Kadri. Hounded a bit by Andy Green, but Leupel following up here. Joffrey Leupel holds, turns and shoots. That's picked off by Henrique. Holding the zone, or at least we thought was Cody Franz, and he reached up high, but it came out and broke the plane. Fans don't like that one bit. Toronto snapped a 7-year playoff drought last season. Since then, the mega deals that the franchise has worked out. Clarkson is a free agent. Dion Phaneuf re-signed for 7 years. Phil Kessel re-upped for 8. Mega contracts valuing together roughly $150 million. There's your core, Chico, for the next 7 years. In the corners, Zidlitsky. Top line back on for the Leafs here. This is Van Riemsdyk. Walks in front, backhand try, and Schneider's got it.
Well, if you're a Devils fan, you're always looking for encouraging signs and statistics, and a lot of times they don't mean a whole lot. But this one might. Back-to-back games this season. Devils got on the win column last night, where they're still under 500, but they're now 4-6-3. And the second game has been good. And tonight they're in a position to add number 8 to that category. But I got to tell you, like, Corey Schneider's made some sharp saves here that are getting overlooked because the game's tied. But that last play there by Van Riemsdyk was a pretty good save, too.
20 stops on the night so far for Corey Schneider. This deflects into the Leafs zone, and Bernier takes no chances with Zajac at the doorstep. So speaking of Corey Schneider, he's making his third consecutive start for just the second time this season. The last such stretch was October 19th to the 24th, and having surrendered one goal on 56 shots in the two games prior to this, look at the shrinking goals against average for Corey Schneider. 1.97, that's fourth best in the NHL coming into tonight's game. Off the draw, controlled here by Gunnarsson. Phaneuf has this for Toronto. Chopped out of the zone by Clarkson. This went into the Leafs bench for a stoppage in play.
Well, Andy Green, not the leader in defensive scoring anymore. That's been taken over by Marek Zidlitsky. Another terrific assist tonight on the goal by Klo. But what the Devils have always hoped for was a lot of input from their defense. And we talked about it for years, but this year it's really fallen into place. And those two guys especially are leading the charge, but Jelena, too, with 16 points, is adding a nice scoring touch from the back line.
This has been typical. Three Devils points tonight on the two goals from defensemen tonight. Green, Jelena, and Zidlitsky all on the score sheet in this tie game. Bernier behind the net leaves this for Dion Phaneuf. His partner Gunnarsson plays it ahead. Nikolai Kuhlman works it across. And now Toronto breaks out with the captain Phaneuf on the puck. Got the shot away. Gloved by Schneider, and he holds on.
Well, this game is slowing to a crawl. Not like we saw in the second period where it was just totally wide open. But Corey Schneider knows what's at stake here. The Devils showed at the top of the show, Pete DeBoer saying he's been waiting for someone to grab the puck and run with it, and Corey Schneider is attempting to do that with his third consecutive win. It'd be the first time that he'd have three victories in a row if he can accomplish that tonight.
Physically, this is fine for him, right?
Oh,
three
yeah.
games in four nights.
Oh yeah, at his age, absolutely.
Carter takes the draw. Carter Ashton and the fourth liner is on for Toronto as it's taken here by Bernier for the Devils, who lifts it ahead. Work back for Jake Gardner. Backhanded into the zone by D'Amico. Ashton giving chase. Loose behind the Devils' net. Steven Gionta worked it free, and now Carter plays it ahead. Bernier on the move, but Gardner there to get it away from him. Deflected away. Carter deflects this back in his own end, and it's taken here by Green. Punched back by Carter. Gionta, nice move at center ice. Drops this back for Michael Ryder, his shot. Saved by Bernier. It is loose. And now we get the whistle. 13:15 to go. Regulation time. 2-2 at the Air Canada Center.
Marek Zidlitsky has always felt the scrutiny of what kind of game he plays. Now look at this here, 25 points, 8 goals and 17 assists, but folks, look at that, plus 5 rating. Very nice on the part of Marek Zadlitsky as he's on the right side of that stat as well as the rest of them. And you were mentioning, what's his career high, Steve, in terms of goals at least?
The very first year he played in the NHL with Nashville, he scored 14 back in the 2003-2004 season. So he's on pace to hover right around that. At the age of 37, he's getting better like a fine wine, Marek Zadlitsky. Played back, Mark Fain in his own zone. Icing's waved off here as Fain plays it across for Green. Works it free to Ryan Clough. That pass came to Tim Gleason, who fires right back in. Each team looking for the breakthrough in a big spot here tonight. Henrique backs it off the boards and picks up Michael Ryder. Ryder is over the line. Control sends it towards goal. Picked off there by Franzen. And he sends Kessel on his way. Here's Phil Kessel with a shot. Zadlitsky filled the lane there. Chipped out of the zone by Henrique. Change for the Devils. 7.5 into the third period. Kadri works it back. This is Dion Phaneuf for Toronto. Cut the tension with a knife here in Toronto.
Oh, this is such a big game, especially for the Leafs.
Nervous anticipation on part of the fans. Yager with a beautiful move, and he fired it wide. Picked up off the backboard and controlled here by Toronto. Raymond punches this ahead. Pass back to Mason Raymond, instead controlled by Zadlitsky. Worked it back blindly to Bryce Salvador. Now Phaneuf's got this for Toronto. Lays it across Carl Gunnarsson. Drops it back. Here's Kadri for the Leafs. His shot saved, made by Corey Schneider. And the whistle as he got pushed back.
Well, it's a good thing that Corey grabs that puck with his mitt, because if it's on his body, that thing might end up now being called a goal. And you're going to see the play here. Nice play by Gunnarsson. He just drops it with a bunch of blue shirts as well as whites trying to defend. That puck is thrown into the maze of humanity. Watch that mitt there, though, of Schneider grabbing that puck. And then you see how he's holding it out there? Watch his left hand. He doesn't want it to cross the goal line. And he makes sure the rest of his body or some of it can be laying beyond the goal line. But not that glove, because that's where the puck is.
Comforting sound of the whistle heard by Corey Schneider. Off the draw, shot by Kessel, save made. On the pad of Corey Schneider, who's been good again tonight. Gardner tries to work it out of the zone. Gianta punches it back in deep. Tyler Bozak works it free to Gardner. As Chico told you, Devils trying to snap a 5-game winless streak against the Leafs. They won every meeting in the regular season last year between the teams. Green plays it ahead. That pass hops over the stick of Ryan Carter and taken here by Toronto. Morgan Rielly for the Leafs. That pass intercepted at center ice. Gianta punches it ahead for Carter. Too far for him. Gardner takes the puck away, winds it around the boards. Picked up here by Kessel. Gianta interrupted that as well. The Leafs top line heads to the bench for a breather as it's Zadlitsky who punches this across. Steered ahead by Henrique, back to Cody Franzen. Tim Gleason has this for the Leafs. His stick failed him. Offside on the call. Just a little bit more on Marek Zadlitsky and where he stacks up against goal-scoring defensemen in the National Hockey League. It's a four-way tie for the league lead. Erik Karlsson, Dustin Byfuglien, Shea Weber, and Tori Krug all with 10. Then there's Chara. And those are the only 5 defensemen in the league with more goals right now than Zadlitsky after the game winner last night.
It's pretty impressive.
Faceoff is at the center dot. Henrique. Kadri. Getting the feeling that one good play might do it. Gleason for Toronto. Into the Devils zone. Salvador does just enough to slow up Kadri. Behind the Devils net. Clough and Zadlitsky work it around, but Cody Franzen picks up the loose puck and punches it back in deep. Marek Zadlitsky works it ahead. Now Ryder collects here and plays it across. The captain, Bryce Salvador, in the center, will fire in. He was at the tail end of his shift, heads to the bench. Worked in deep by the Devils, but Franzen is able to take it away and send Kadri on his way. Backhand pass across. Lupul trying to get on the end of this. Volchenkov sweeps it away from him. Devils keep it moving. Ryan Klo tries to get it out of the zone, cannot. Raymond punches it back in deep. Now Lupul with the puck for Toronto. Gives it back to Mason Raymond in the corner. Volchenkov and Green together tie up Kadri. And worked ahead to the stick of Michael Ryder. Better than halfway through period three. Tie game. Ryder's shot blocked away by Gunnarsson and picked up here by Phaneuf. Leafs captain can't clear the zone. Mark Fain instead sends it back into the corner. Zubras behind the Toronto goal line. Got it away from Phaneuf. Yager in the corner. The trio, Zubras, Zajac, and Yager trying to make it happen here in the third. And the Leafs send it back the length of the ice. Let's see if the Devils get the icing call. No, it's waved off as Salvador goes back to play. Giontas sealed off at center ice by Kuhlman. Bouncing puck at center. Gobbled up here by David Clarkson. The ex-Devil tries to pull the trigger. Partially fanned on the shot. And Zydlitsky sends this out to center. Bouncing puck picked up here by Reed Boucher. Can he get a step on Riley? Good shot. Save made by Bernier. Boucher with one goal since his NHL call-up. Clarkson streaking down the right side. Andy Green is there to deal with him. Deep in the zone, Clarkson takes a hit from Mike Sisla. Still battling for it. Picked up here by New Jersey. Gianta punches it ahead. Pass gets here to Boucher. Here's Boucher. Tries to play it across. He's got Sisla cutting for the net. Riley was able to recover, but Boucher turns and shoots and fires wide. Henrique back to the point. Volchenkov with a drive. Picked up out of the corner here by Fain. He's checked by Kuhlman. Volchenkov punches it back in deep. Clarkson, he's been on the ice for a while. Ties up with Klo. Kept in by the Devils and punched right back in deep. Fain will pinch in on the near side. Sends it towards goal. It went through Bernier's crease, and Kessel is on the ice to lift it away. 7:20 to go in regulation time. Devils looking for the goal that will get the win streak to three. Picked up at center. Bozak drops it back for Kessel. Here's Phil Kessel cutting to the center. Puck checked away by Klo. Drop back here for Gleason. Plays it across for Phaneuf. And the slap shot off the mark. It went off the glass. And we get the stoppage with 7:02 to go. 2-2 it continues to be in Toronto. Tonight's upcoming schedule brought to you by Lexus. This is the rest of the road trip. We're in Montreal on MSG Plus Tuesday night. At Colorado, Devils Avalanche for the first time, 9 o'clock Thursday. And then the road trip concludes in the Wild West against the Coyotes. Saturday, 8 o'clock, that game on MSG. Islanders came back to beat Dallas tonight 4-2. Rangers have a 4-1 lead over the Flyers. Carcillo with his first goal for New York. The Devils deadlocked with the Leafs and a good one here in Toronto. Under 7 minutes to go, it's 2-2. Three of the four goals in tonight's game scored in a pretty wild second period. Yager at the line, plays it ahead. Zajac tied up by Kuhlman, but the puck taken here by Zubras. Plays it across. Yager was cutting for the net. Trying to control the puck under pressure from McClennick. Jaromir Yager works it across. Andy Green picks it up off the boards. Hounded by Clarkson, able to play it back in deep. Here's Gunnarsson for Toronto, sends Kuhlman on his way. Nikolai Kuhlman, but Clarkson was the man offside.
Well, it's interesting, the two mindsets of the teams. Devils are content, Steve, to come up as a unit on their breakout. I'm watching the Leafs. They're more of a long home run pass team, and that's what they're looking for. And they're waiting for that one opportunity to spring the long bomb, but so far the Devils have made sure that hasn't happened here in the third. But you talked about the tension and pressure. Can you imagine on, we just saw coach for the Leafs, Randy
Carlisle. I mean, there's tremendous pressure. I don't think he's in danger of being fired. I know he's not. But still, that's the talk around town. And to relieve that, his team needs to get him some wins, or it's going to continue and probably accelerate.
Lupul turns around, shot blocked away. Joffrey Lupul again, another try. Devils get in the way of that and work it ahead. Penalty coming up against the Leafs.
Wow. And this is a trip.
A huge Devils power play when we come back with 5:54 left.
We're back at the ACC, and no matter when this one ends, regulation, overtime, or a shootout, we will have the Devils' E-Sherns postgame for you. We'll have Coach DeBoer. We'll have all the locker room interviews. Steven Chico will have all the highlights. They'll break it down. We've got the E-Sherns postgame coming up as soon as this one ends.
Thank you, Deb. 5:54 away. Joffrey Lupul for tripping. Devils power play. Jelena and Green are the point men. The Henrique line starts it with Ryder and Klo. Adam Henrique has had a good night in the circle, and he wins this back. Devils set up. Klo back to the point where Green has it. Plays it across. Jelena walks in and shoots. Save made by Jonathan Bernier. And with Henrique at the doorstep, they get the quick whistle.
Adam Henrique is just so focused and determined tonight. Like I say, this is a home game for him. And he has been all around the net, winning faceoffs, scoring a goal, and doing a lot of stuff we're watching here. He's making sure that he stays outside the realm of Bernier. And so a good start to this power play by New Jersey, Steve. So 5:41 to go. This is just magnified with what's at stake for both teams.
Henrique again won it back, but this time comes back to the neutral zone, and Jelena will collect. 20 seconds elapsed in the man advantage. Eric Jelena starts the rush here for the Devils. Skates it in himself, dishes across for Ryder, but the play is offside.
Well, Michael Ryder really enjoying playing with Ryan Klo, who's also from Newfoundland. You know, that's a ways away. I've said it before. To get from here to Newfoundland, where they're from, is farther than if they went from there to England. So Newfoundland stuck way out. Like, they have their own time zone. We used to watch Hockey Night in Canada. It was 8 o'clock Eastern time, 8:30 Newfoundland time. So they're sitting there with a half hour difference from the rest of any other province in Canada. So it's a unique place, and these players are enjoying representing that province.
Green fires in. Deflects off the Newfoundland man, Ryan Klo. Kuhlman behind the net. Gobbled up here by the Leafs and cleared away by McClement. Schneider leaves this for Andy Green. Devils start up again. Here's Green on the move for the Devils. Plays it across. Now Ryder winds it around the boards. Klo waiting for it on the opposite side. Stripped off his stick by Cody Franzen, who sends it the length of the ice. 45 to go in the man advantage. Zidlitsky's turn to try to make something happen. Marek Zidlitsky to center. Plays it across. Now Jágr dishes off here for Boucher. Devils got caught up, and they're offside once again.
Well, Jaromír Jágr not happy, I think, with the way things have unfolded this game, but it's not from lack of trying. It's just everything he's trying to create tonight is just kind of broken down. But he and his line are playing better, Steve. They had that little funk for about four games where they seemed to be a little on the tired side, but that is behind them now as they're starting to regain the form they had earlier.
Jágr in the corner, works it back. Zajac covering the point. Final 23 seconds of the Devils' power play. Travis Zajac across to Zidlitsky. He shoots, that deflects up high and out of play. The faceoff will stay in the Toronto zone.
This is a big rule change here where Zidlitsky has his shot deflected way outside the top of the circle, but a few years ago they said we're not going to face it off from where the puck was deflected over the glass. We're always going to bring it back down into the circle, and that's a real advantage for the attacking team, in this case the Devils.
Zajac, 17 seconds left in the power play.
It's a big face-off win by McClement and a big clear for Toronto. Schneider leaves behind his net. Here's Marek Zadlitsky. Final seconds of the Devils' power play. Looking for one last rush here, and Travis Ajak skates it in himself. He'll get chased, steered into the corner by Bernier. Joffrey Lupul is out of the box. We're back to 5-on-5. Puck taken here by Jager. Throws it back. Look back to the point. Zadlitsky with a shot that's redirected and tipped wide. Kuhlman punches it out to center and plays it ahead. Lupul met by Zadlitsky. Delivered the hip check at center and taken here by Green. Steered ahead by Gianta. Back to give chase. Morgan Riley winds it around the boards. Puck never got to Phil Kessel. Deep in the zone, Gardner. Tied up by a couple of Devils. Ryan Carter tries to work it back to the point. Now Gianta into the corner. Bernier for Carter. Good pressure by this unit. Turnaround shot by Carter. Deflected in front and taken away by Riley. The Leafs skated away. Play it across. Devils intercept, and now Gianta has this at center ice. The Gianta line heads off at the tail end. Here comes Kessel out of his own end for Toronto. To Van Riemsdyk. Back to Kessel. Drops it back. They pick up the trailer. Gleason and a shot blocked away by Steven Gianta, who heads to the bench. Hunched over. Work back towards the point. Franzen with a shot. That's steered aside by Schneider. Close. Skates it away for the Devils. Under 2.5 to play. Worked ahead for Henrik. Adam Henrik. Backhand shot that went wide and caroms all the way back to center. Valchenkov fires in for the Devils. Mason Raymond picks this up. Drops it back for Gleason. Lupul for Toronto. Works it ahead to center. Kadri on the puck. The Leafs offside gaining the zone.
Well, Steven Gianta's at the end of a shift. Remember, his two line mates are on the bench, but he's got one last play to make, and that is to go down and block a dangerous slapper from Franzen, who can really pound it. It stung Steven. He would have stayed out there and finished the shift, but he was really hurt, so he just went to the bench. But that's winning hockey, Steve. Game's on the line, 2 minutes to go. Could have resulted in a big chance for the Leafs, and Gianta single-handedly shut it all down.
Telling Rich Stinziano, the trainer, I'm okay, shaking it off. Bouncing puck at center ice, picked up here by New Jersey. Punched ahead for Jager, waiting for it at the line. It's a hand pass against Knuff. Face-off is in the Leafs zone with 1:44 to go.
Well, back-to-back games that are real nail-biters if you're a Devils fan. And, of course, last night it was Florida, and tonight Leafs. But Devils have worked hard to get here, Steve. They've had some good chances. Both goalies, much like last night, have made some key saves. And Schneider's been very, very good. And Ryan Clough, with his first of the year, has got to really help his confidence going forward from here. And it's nice to see for Ryan, because they're going on this long road trip, and you want him to get that, as he said, the Dev out of the way. That was a major thing he just wanted. Just wanted to get that first one and move on.
Well, his season's got some real traction now. Clough. Franzen interrupted by Ryan Clough. Bouncing puck. Kessel tries to feather one in deep. It's Bryce Salvador, who sends it back out to center. Cody Franzen on the puck here for Toronto. Steered ahead by Bozak, but Zadlitsky. That puck had to be played by Jonathan Bernier, and look out.
Not only played, but he had to tie it up. That's not what he was looking for, Steve. Face-off deep in his own end. You know, and it must get lodged in his pad, and he can't get loose. And then, see, now his focus is down here, so he doesn't really want to let it go loose. He doesn't know what's coming at him. Oh, it's caught in his blocker. And he just says, I'm just going to take my chances and get the whistle.
1:14 left. Zajac, Jager, and Zubras come on. Points are such a premium, especially the way the race is in the Eastern Conference. We documented that at the point. Each of these teams a minute 10 away from getting at least a point. See if it gets that far. Knuff tried to play it ahead. Controlled it
with a hand pass again, but it's picked up here by Andy Green instead. Here's Green. Controls down low. Throws one in front. That deflected off and up. Controlled here by Zajac. He's tied up by Bozak. Loose puck controlled here by Zubris. Works it behind the net. Now Jágr controls. Able to shield it away from Gunnarsson. Jaromír Jágr gets rid of Gunnarsson with one hand and still controls. Jágr again, back to the point. Green, soft shot, deflected away by Fanuf. Picked up here by Zubris. Slapped back to the point and Fane. Gets it back from Jágr. His shot blocked away in front. That's Fanuf, who appears roughed up on the play, but gets back to deliver a hit on Jágr. Devils stay with it. Here's Dina Zubris. 15 seconds to go. Fane with a shot. Blocked away and taken away by Fanuf. Back into the Devils' zone, but Clement will try to get on this. Final seconds of regulation time. 2 seconds and one. And with Bernier on the puck, that'll do it. Overtime at the Air Canada Centre. The Devils earn a point for the fourth consecutive game. Welcome back to Toronto. Devils and Maple Leafs are tied at two. It's Jonathan Bernier and Corey Schneider. Bernier starting for the eighth time in nine. Schneider his third consecutive start tonight. They've each been good.
They have. And the Devils' last four wins, 2-1, 2-1, 1-0, 2-1 in OT. And let's look at some of the action where the Devils win this one. That's Mark Fane. And that had to be last year, even the year before. It was Mark's wearing number 29. And I remember that shot. It was a big win that night. And can he do it again? But the Devils, well, if they win, will end up scoring three, or at least be credited with it, which will be quite a goal explosion for them. But they are comfortable in this situation. And there you see both teams over 500. In the overtime records, but the Devils so much more experience in these ones, having a 6-3 record. Zadlitsky the hero last night.
They'll start out with Henrique and Ryder together. Off the draw, controlled by the Leafs, and played back for Morgan Rielly. Lupo plays it across, picks up Rielly, poke checked away by Zadlitsky. Now Jelinek plays it ahead for Ryder. Puts the brakes on and waits for help. Ryder plays it across, got by a couple of players, and now Rielly takes the puck away for Toronto. Icing against the Leafs, 27 seconds into overtime.
Well, let's see who Pete DeBoer puts out here. We got Jágr, and this time it's going to be Zubris. Taking the draw because it's on the left side of the ice. Travis would probably be there if it was on the right. But they got the big boy right here at the point.
Off the draw. Jágr able to control. He crossed up with Zadlitsky. Now Jágr takes it off the boards. Backhand try by Jágr is blocked away and taken here by Gardner. Punched out to center. Zadlitsky gets it back to Jaromír Jágr. Over the line, pass across for Zubris. Devils are called for an offside.
Jaromír Jágr with a big assist last night, surpassed, as we mentioned, Mario Lemieux. And there's lots left, he said again last night, that I'm not retiring. Don't even start to talk that way when you're around me, because that has not entered my mindset yet, and I could see why he wouldn't. The way he's been playing and the energy level that has come back to him. And again tonight, he's been pretty dominant in terms of protecting the puck.
Set up the game winner in overtime last night. He is still tied with Marc Messier in total goals scored. Here's Fane for the Devils. His shot blocked away by Jonathan Bernier and deflected out of play.
And that'll be in the zone. Oh, we just showed you Mark scoring a couple years ago an overtime goal, and I almost thought, whoa, is this deja vu we're watching here? Nice play again by the Devils to get the puck to the middle of the ice. That was Ryan Clough with another nifty pass to Fane.
See what the Devils construct here. This was the faceoff dot that produced the game winner last night. Zajac
This time Gunnarsson kicks it away from Jágr, and it's controlled here by Dion Phaneuf. Carl Gunnarsson takes this and plays it across. McClement over the line for the Leafs. His shot swallowed up by Andy Green. He lost his stick. Green still trying to control. McClement trying to dig it away from him. Worked loose. Zajac won the battle along the boards, but punched back in by Nikolaj Kulomin. Green has the stick back and gives here to Fain. Played ahead for Jaromír Jágr. Jágr is over the line. Dropped it back. Able to control here as Yelena walks in and shoots, and a save by Jonathan Bernier.
Hey, that move through the neutral zone by Jágr had a hum going through the crowd here. It was like he was downhill skiing. Watch him weave here. Leafs think they got him. No one beats that guy. Then just dropped it just inside the blue line. But Jelena, kicking it to his stick, fires it in the bread basket of the goaltender Bernier.
Off the draw. One back by Toronto, but the puck taken here by the Devils and worked back to Jelena at the point. Here's Reed Boucher in overtime. Plays it across. Pass intended for Zydlitsky. Drop back here. And it's Riley who has this for the Maple Leafs. Franzen picks up Kessel at center ice. Kessel weaves his way away from Boucher. Gives here to Bozak. That deflected off a leg in front and taken away by the Devils. Here's Boucher all alone. He's working one on three. Takes it wide and fires it around the boards, and it caroms all the way back to the Devils' end. Fain has it midway through overtime. 2-2 game. Mark Fain for the Devils plays it ahead. Here's Adam Henry. Plays it across. Michael Ryder puts the brakes on. Controls. Trying to get a shot away. Couldn't pull the trigger. Taken away by the Leafs, and Gunnarsson controls here for Toronto. Plays it across. Pass intercepted by Andy Green. Ryder on his way. Threw it across. Out of the reach of Adam Henry. Devils change all four skaters. Here comes Toronto the other way. Mason Raymond over the line. Plays it across. Gunnarsson punches it in deep. Van Riemsdyk crosses up with Raymond. Ryan Klo is there to take the puck away. Jelena has it for New Jersey. Lost control. Van Riemsdyk took it away. Raymond has it for Toronto. Chased back out to center. And he'll wait for reinforcements. Here's Jake Gardner for the Leafs. Minute and a half to go in the overtime. Knocked off the stick of Joffrey Lupul, but taken here by Gardner. Gardner across. Lupul at the doorstep. Centering try picked up instead by Klo. Golden chance for the Leafs, and now Zajac skates it away for the Devils. He's got Andy Green with him. Plays it across, picks up Jágr off the boards. Plays it across for Jelena. Tried to make the move down low. Zajac has it. Jágr the one-timer, and he fired it wide. Jaromír Jágr again comes away with it. One-time shot, a blast by Zajac. Drop back for Jágr. Jaromír Jágr threw it back. Lupul with the intercept and works it away. Here come the Leafs in transition. Kadri drops it across. Riley with the shot, and he fired it wide. 40 seconds left. Long pass by Jágr. This is onside. Zajac will track it down. Tries to get it away from Riley, who's able to recover. Fire wagon here in overtime. Kadri over the line. Sealed off by Zydlitsky. Marek Zydlitsky holds. Devils looking for one more opportunity here in the overtime. Long pass ahead. This is gobbled up by Zubras. Feathers it ahead for Henrique. Adam Henrique plays it across for the cutting Fain. Caroms around the boards. Picked up here by Zydlitsky. Marek Zydlitsky takes it down low. 7 seconds left. Trying to create a chance in front. It's loose. It deflects back to Bernier, who's got it. My goodness.
Well, that was a sweep shot by Dinas Zubras. Whoa. Well, let's see where we're going to pick this up. Here's the Devils on the rush once again. Boy, they've done a good job of controlling that puck in the Leafs offensive zone. And there's the one by Jágr, who can't maneuver on net. It goes wide, but he goes and gets it again, recovers it, gives it to Zajac. Travis just shot it wide, and so did the defenseman Riley. And there's that sweep shot by Zubras. Well, 2.5 seconds. Can the Devils do it again, Steve?
It's in the other faceoff dot. No timeout to talk about it. Faceoff won by Bozak anyway. Okay, shootout this time. The Devils will try to win a shootout for the first time this season when we come back. The shootout. Six times the Devils have experienced it, 0 for 6 so far this year. The Maple Leafs have 7 wins in a shootout this season, only 14 in regulation or overtime. You might recall the Winter Classic. They defeated the Red Wings in a shootout. Tyler Bozak was the man who finished off that game with the deciding goal for the Leafs. Jaromír Jágr would prefer not to see this in the league. We're told he's going to start this off for the Devils. Ryan Clough, the second shooter. Reed Boucher, the only Devil to put one in the shootout this year, will be the anchorman.
Well, we'll see. It'd be interesting. Ryan said to Deb, I usually do that in the shootout, the move that we saw. But here it was a little easier because it was in the game and the pressure was different. But Ryan Clough has been, as we know, Steve, from history, a good shootout marksman. Mm-hmm. And then for the Leafs, you got Van Riemsdyk, Lupo, and Bozak. And that means that Kessel, who you might suspect would be in the mix, will be fourth or beyond.
Van Riemsdyk will get it started. He had the game-deciding goal in the first meeting with the Devils this year back on the 8th of November. He has a goal in tonight's game as well. Corey Schneider stands at the other end of the ice. Here we go in Toronto. James Van Riemsdyk to get it started for the Leafs. Walks in on Schneider. Backhand, he scores.
Nah, he just makes it look too easy. And I know what you're thinking, folks, but he's got a wicked wrist shot, although there he puts it to his backhand pretty early, but does make a nice shot over the pad and glove, so it's up to Jágr to try and tie it.
That's Jágr in his career. Looking for his first shootout goal this season. Jágr in on Bernier. Nifty move, and it's poked away by Jonathan Bernier.
Well, you never know what's going through this man's mind here. And he kind of slows it down and then, oh, it's a poke check. Didn't see the poke check at first. Nice play by Bernier to help himself.
Here's Joffrey Lupl. 30-year-old winger, fourth year with the Leafs. Can give his team a commanding edge here. Lupl in on Schneider. Shoots and he hit the post.
Yeah, Lupl just moving that puck around a little bit. Corey Schneider's saying, it's all I gave him. Wasn't worried. Ooh, boy, that was a weird shot. Almost looked like he misses it here, Steve. Sure, he comes off the puck. But as we looked there, there was nothing of net to shoot. That was only post.
Ryan Clough, his first goal as a Devil tonight on the shootout. Denied by Bernier.
Oh, tough luck for Ryan Clough. He went the opposite, Steve, to what he did on the breakaway. But let's see if he's got some room over here. He's got to get it up. Oh, he tries to hook it around the skate of Bernier, but there was only net, side of the net to shoot at once he got to the goal line.
Tyler Bozak in position to win the game for the Maple Leafs here if he scores on Schneider.
Now they're taking some time here, Steve. They're almost calling a timeout. We don't know why. I don't think they're gonna look at the post shot that Lupo took, I don't think. Do they have the wrong list? Are the wrong names on the list? Just not quite sure what's going on.
Well, whatever it is, Bozak is getting back into position now to take his turn. They're all standing at the Air Canada Center. Tyler Bozak in on Corey Schneider. He shoots and he fired wide. Devil's still alive.
Well, the only man that scored a shootout goal, pop it over the bench. And nice challenge there by Schneider. Well, there's a kid, one for one. And don't underestimate him, Steve. He's got nothing to lose.
Here's Boucher trying to keep the Devils alive. He shoots. No go. The Maple Leafs win in the shootout. The final score is 3-2.
Well, they're out to congratulate both goalies who were brilliant in this game. I don't know if Reed shot it wide or not, but this is amazing again, Steve, that nary a Devil could find the back of the net in the shootout once again. And here we'll see. What does Reed do here now? Does it hit the blocker? Hard to tell. I think he just shot it wide. So the Leafs win this one, and it's time now, though, for our goal of the game, and it's brought to you by Nissan. Choose Nissan today for great offers on our most innovative lineup ever. Shop at ChooseNissan.com. The only goal of the shootout, again, it's that guy from New Jersey, James Van Riemsdyk, with the beautiful, I don't know, I mean, it's just so subtle, you think the goalie should stop it. But, Steve, if you overplay the backhand, then he's going to take it to his forehand and go over the blocker. Instead, he just rifles it off the inside of the pipe over the pad, and the Leafs can breathe a little sigh of relief. And you know what, Steve? Devils could feel good about their game as well.
They earned the point on the road to get the road trip started. A final chance right there, Boucher. He missed on the Montreal. Devils Canadians Tuesday night at 7:30. But the Esurance Devils postgame show is coming up next from Toronto. Keep it here.